My name is Allie Henderson. I am from Kelowna, BC. I ride freestyle motocross. I'm one of the only women in the world that jumps and tricks a 75-foot gap. Or at least I was prior to a crash I had in Yakima, Washington in September of 2013. I was doing a freestyle show down there. It was one of my first freestyle shows. I haven't done that many, so I was a little nervous about doing it, but I went and everything was good. I was excited, I was feeling confident, and I get there and we set up the mobile. It was my first time jumping a mobile landing, which is a man-made landing versus dirt, and I overjumped it. My stomach hit my bars and I winded myself and a little bit more. Ended up going to the Yakima Hospital where they did a CT scan and discovered that my pancreas was bruised. So we drove home and I knew something wasn't right. Like there was just so much pain. And as soon as I got home, it was a 7-hour drive home, and got home, slept for 3 hours, back in the hospital. And it was at the Kelowna Hospital that they realized that my pancreas was not bruised, but that it had in fact hit my spine on impact and split in half, and that I had to go in for emergency surgery to have the majority of my pancreas removed. I spent 5 weeks in the hospital, in and out, after my surgery. In that time, I had two surgeries. I had a vacuum over my stomach at one point because it helped to heal my incision that had split open. So I had a vacuum on my stomach for a few days. I got lots of needles, lots of morphine, lots of the fun stuff, but and a really, really big scar to conclude it. Growing up, I rode horses. I always wanted to ride in the Olympics, and I would spend all my time at barns and just riding, doing anything, having anything to do with horses. When I graduated from high school, I ended up moving over to Europe. That was just the best place for me to be in the position I was in. Riding is a very expensive sport, and I couldn't afford to do it at the levels that I wanted to do it at here. So I ended up over in Europe, where it was just a better opportunity for me. After several years of riding, it just stopped being fun. It started being all about the politics and who you rode with and what you were wearing. And it wasn't about the talent or the hard work that, you know, we all put into it. That was never acknowledged. And I just felt a large dissatisfaction with the sport, with my involvement with it. So I quit. And I ended up going to school, which isn't really for me, but I went because, you know, that's what you do. You're supposed to grow up and go to school. So I did. Then I ended up meeting a guy named Bruce Cook. And Bruce rides freestyle motocross professionally. And I remember when I went up there once to watch him, you know, do his thing up at his property, I think he was brought me up there mostly just to show off, and I remember seeing it and being like, I want to do that. Like, that looks fun. And I asked if I could try, and he let me try and started off with a 10-foot gap, and now it's 75 and it's tricks and it's different arenas, different setups, and it's been a crazy 2 years. Bruce really allowed me to try. There aren't a lot of people that would let a 23-year-old woman with very little dirt bike experience jump ramps on their property or even give someone in that situation the time of day to try. You know, there was nothing about me that said, this girl's gonna be great at freestyle. You know, I was 23, I rode horses all my life. But it made me happy and he helped me. So I'm incredibly grateful for him and his involvement. I wouldn't be following this dream if I had never met Bruce Cook. So in January of 2014, Bruce was accepted a spot on the Nitro Circus Tour. He was going to be the first person to ever attempt to land a double front flip. Anyone who has followed the story or follows the sport knows how that went. Bruce is paralyzed from the waist down. He landed in a way where he actually broke himself in half. Broke his spine, ripped his spinal cord, and he's paralyzed. Being so close to him and close to just having so much history with him and having him really be the reason that I've even gotten to where I am in this sport, and then to see, you know, I have my own encounter with jeopardizing my health, and seeing someone who I've looked up to who's got more skill, more confidence, more just natural talent than I ever will, and to see him in the situation he is in, it makes you question things. Was it worth it? You know, that could happen to anybody. Through my crash and then seeing what Bruce has been through, I've still decided to move forward with the sport and to get back on those ramps. I'm scared, and I see Bruce and I see my scar and I think, but I get on my bike and I'm happy, and it's scary and it's fun and I think that's what I need. So, and I just keep going and pray that if I'm meant to go down, it's not too hard. So I've been back on my bike for 3 months now, and it's been the most frustrating and rewarding journey. It's just about baby steps. You know, I've been frustrated by the fact that I can't do what I once did. I get frustrated that it's not just about going out playing anymore now that I know the consequences. You know, it isn't just playtime like maybe it once was. You know, I understand in the moment that I have this incredible freedom, the next moment I can lose so much freedom. I got myself a new bike, which really helped with my head game. I've spent less time on ramps and more time on the motocross track, so that's just allowed for me to just become a better rider. You know, learn how to jump different gaps, different distances, play in different kinds of dirt, and you know, just really build on my skill set and really build on my confidence and just take the baby steps that are necessary in order to get back to where I was. Sometimes I question myself as to why I keep going after something. And being a woman in the sport, there's not really a lot of places for me to go, nor do I want to make money riding a dirt bike. So sometimes it's, you know, I'm like, I question myself and why I'm doing it. But there's just something about when you turn at a ramp, it's one of the only things that makes me feel so present. Because, I mean, if you're thinking about anything else, you're risking your life, and you turn at that ramp, and it's just you and that dirt bike, that ramp, that landing, and making it all kind of come together. And it's just, I just feel present and in the moment and engaged with life. And it's the only other thing that really makes me feel that way is yoga. So it's just something that in this busy, hectic mind that I have, it's almost calming to chase something like that. I have a very special place in my heart for women. I feel like we're taught that, you know, we need to be beautiful, we need to look a certain way, we need to play this role of that, or this we don't buy into this belief that our self-worth is completely related to the way that we look. And I've bought into that for years, and it wasn't until I got on my bike and kind of discovered the talent that I have and discovered, you know, when you kind of pull things out from within, and that's where you're happy. Because even if you're the prettiest person in the world, no one really cares. And beauty is subjective, and I just feel like there's way too much value put on it when it comes, like, as a woman. I want women to be better. I want them to strive for greatness. I want them to challenge their fears and go for their goals and their dreams. And I think the first step to doing that is to letting go of this belief that how you look is who you are. And I want to role model what it looks like to empower yourself and to find the power in yourself to being great at whatever it is that you actually love to do. Just do what you love. There's something to be said for that. We don't do it often enough. Just do what you love and do it often. Yeah. ¶¶